extra, extra, read all about it.
Oh, hi there. You want to know all about this film? Well, you got to get yourself an EPK.
Hello, filmmakers, Ash here, and welcome to Film It Yourself. You've finished your film and you're ready to submit to film festivals, but before you do, you're going to want to make sure you've got your EPK, or electronic press kit, on point. An electronic press kit is a digital document that has various information and images about your film. It's a vital piece of marketing for your film when submitting to film festivals, and making sure it's the best it can be is a key piece to getting your film accepted into festivals. So, let's go over all the things that need to be included in an electronic press kit for film, including some tips on how you can really make your film EPK shine. First up, you want the first page of your EPK to prominently display your film's title. A good way to do this is by featuring the poster of your film. This way, you have your film's title along with some compelling imagery. Next up, you want to include your film's logline and synopsis. These are key descriptions film festivals will use in marketing materials, such as festival handouts and screening details online. Note, however, that some film festivals might ask for your synopsis to be a specific length, or even to provide two or three of varying lengths. So keep this version brief and then provide them with a more lengthy one once you've been accepted. After that, you want to provide technical specs for your film. This includes the title, genre, production year, country of origin, language, runtime, screen ratio, and sound format. Again, this is super important information for a film festival director, as they will need to know this info to plan out the technical side of screenings, as well as program film blocks. So, make sure it says accurate as possible, especially your runtime, as this is a huge deciding factor for festival directors. Trust me, they will not be happy if you give them a festival screener that's even 30 seconds longer than what you listed in your EPK. And pro tip here, also make sure you're including all these technical specs on your Film Freeway project page, as this will be the first place festival directors will look. Next up, make sure you provide bios for the key crew members on your film. These are people like the director, producer, and writer, but if you have other crew members that might have some notoriety, then listing them can help your film's marketability to film festivals. Film festivals love it when highbrow talent is attached to the films they are screening, and they will promote that as much as they can. And speaking of talent, next, make sure you include bios for your actors and actresses. This is usually just your leading characters, but again, if you have a name actor in your film that isn't necessarily a leading character, it's great to list them here as well, as film festivals love, love, love having celebrities in their films. Like, seriously, they are as obsessed with celebrities as Gen Z is with TikTok. And don't get me wrong, TikTok's pretty great. Optionally, after your leading cast, you can include a quick overview of all the crew involved in the film, and it doesn't hurt to have a photo. This isn't necessarily required, but can be a nice touch. And finally, you want to include some promotional stills from your film. Now, note that these are not behind-the-scenes photos. They should either be slick marketing photos you took for the film or stills pulled from the film itself. I highly recommend having a combo of both, as film festivals will love to use promo photos for online marketing, but will most likely want a still pulled from the film for handouts. And final pro tip for you, make sure you have fun with it and make it visually appealing. Making your EPK's look and feel match your film goes a long way and shows your film is the full marketing package. Now that you've seen these film EPK examples, your electronic press kit is sure to shine. Or glow, I guess, because it's digital. And if you want feedback on your film before submitting it to festivals, you can get my personal feedback by supporting me on Patreon. Plus, I have other different tiers that get you early access to all of my videos, downloads for my filmmaking templates, and access to my filmmaker chats, where I chat with other filmmakers to get their tips. You can find a link to my Patreon account in the description below. This just in, hot off the presses, filmmaker gets into film festival.